Do you know me? Maybe you recognize me.
Chances are you've probably seen me around the halls at school, in classes, or on the tennis court.
From the outside, we look like every other kid you know. I Bollywood dance, and Charlie does gymnastics just like other kids. But on the inside, we have type 1 diabetes.
Diabetes isn't contagious, so you can't catch it from me when we sit next to one another at lunch. In fact, no one really knows why some kids get it and some don't.
So far, there is not a cure, but we can spot the symptoms. And when diagnosed, type 1 diabetes is manageable. Having good management can keep me healthy and strong, just like you.
So I bet you're curious, what is type 1 diabetes?
An organ in your body called the pancreas produces an important hormone called insulin. Insulin is what turns the food you eat into energy. We all know how important energy is to kids, but my body doesn't make any insulin. So when I eat, the sugar in my blood never turns into energy. The blood sugar levels just get higher and higher, no place to go. If left untreated, my blood sugar levels would go through the roof, putting me at risk for organ damage to my heart, liver, kidneys, and even my eyes.
But don't worry, luckily there are ways I can add insulin to my body and keep my blood sugar levels within my target range, just like yours.
Throughout the day, I check my blood sugar levels. There are two ways to check blood sugar. Some kids use a glucose meter and others use a CGM. You may see me checking my blood sugar in the classroom, before I eat, or begin any kind of physical exercise.
Keeping blood sugars in range for someone with type 1 is very important. Each person has a set target range. Once I know my blood sugar levels, I can determine how much insulin I need to give.
Kids with type 1 diabetes give insulin shots several times a day or use a device called an insulin pump. You'll see me give myself insulin before meals and to correct when I'm above my blood sugar range.
I use multiple daily injections through an insulin pen or a syringe. It hurts a little, but I'm used to it.
I use a pump and I wear it on my belt or put it in my pocket. There are many models out there and might even look like cell phones. Others use a patch pump where a pod-like device holds the insulin and using Bluetooth talks to a device. The pump gives me a small, steady dose of insulin through a small plastic tube inserted into my skin. When I eat, I just push this button and it gives me an extra amount of insulin.
Sounds simple, right?
Not really. I'm a kid, not a scientist. Figuring out how much insulin I need depends on math and a lot of other factors that my diabetes healthcare team figures out for me.
They include how much I exercise, what I eat, my blood sugar level, my stress level, if I feel like I am getting sick or have an infection, even how I am growing.
When I play tennis, I check my blood sugar before, during, and after the match.
I love to have a sleepover, but I have to be careful when I'm playing and having fun that my blood sugars don't drop too low. I need to have snacks ready.
It takes a lot of hard work to keep my blood sugars in the target range. I can do everything my doctors and parents tell me to do, but it still can go too high or low. It's not my fault.
There are basically two different problems I face with keeping my blood sugars within range. The first is if my levels become too high. I may need your help.
A few of the most common symptoms that tell you my blood sugar levels are too high are thirst, inability to concentrate, frequent urination, and/or blurry vision.
High blood sugars in the short term won't put me in danger right away. So if you see these warning signs, don't panic.
But if my blood sugar's high over an extended amount of time, then we've got a big problem.
If you recognize the signs of high blood sugar, and we've confirmed it's high by checking it with my glucose monitor and or my CGM, give me water or a sugar-free drink. Continue to monitor my blood sugar levels and keep me from engaging in physical activity. If my blood sugars are extremely high, immediately call my caregivers or physician. Additional insulin should only be given if specifically instructed to do so.
The other problem I can have is if my blood sugar drops too low.
This is much more dangerous because I can become confused and I can become severely low very quickly.
If this happens, I face unconsciousness and I won't be able to raise my blood sugar by myself. I will need immediate help.
Here are some symptoms to look for if you think my blood sugars may be going low: shakiness, sweating, irritability, and drowsiness. the most severe symptom of low blood sugar levels are convulsions, seizures, and unconsciousness.
If I do become unconscious, immediately give me an emergency dose of glucagon and then call 911.
Low blood sugar levels are considered anything below 70. In this range, some kids will start to show symptoms while others may still feel perfectly normal. Take action based on the readings and not just how I may or may not be acting.
If you suspect I might be experiencing low blood sugar levels, or if I tell you I don't feel well, help me treat my low blood sugars with fast-acting sugar. If I need to go to the nurse's office after I treat my low, have someone accompany me. That way, everybody knows I'm safe.
There really are so many different reasons of why my blood sugar fluctuates. I do my best to avoid this, but sometimes it just happens.
If I'm experiencing a low or a high blood sugar, I'm really not feeling like myself, and that affects my ability to think properly. It requires time to come back into range, and I may need to reschedule a test or finish an assignment.
By reviewing the signs and symptoms of these regularly and how to treat these, you can prepare yourself in case of an emergency. We're regular kids. We just have type 1 diabetes.
So don't be afraid.
Learn all you can.
And smile at me the next time you see me, because I'm just like you.
If you have specific questions about a child in your care, contact the relevant diabetes provider and go to the JDRF website,